गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज योर ईवीएस क्लास वंस अगेन. सी चिल्ड्रन, दैट सेमिस्टर वन बुक सोशल स्टडीज, ऑल द पार्ट्स आई हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड, ऑल द लेसन ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड. साइंस ओनली वन वाज रिमेनिंग, दैट वाज लेसन नंबर 7, सेफ्टी एट फर्स्ट एड, दैट ओनली विल डू एंड विल कंप्लीट इट. सो नेक्स्ट टाइम ऑनवर्ड्स मे बी स्कूल विल ओपन, विल स्टार्ट विथ सेमिस्टर टू बुक. सो कीप द बुक रेडी, सेमिस्टर टू बुक कीप इट रेडी. नाउ साइंस, दिस वन आई एम टेलिंग यू, लेसन नंबर 7, सेफ्टी एंड फर्स्ट एड. चैप्टर इज अबाउट सेफ्टी एंड फर्स्ट एड. बिफोर आई प्रोसीड, प्रीवियस ईवीएस क्लास व्हाट वी लर्न, लास्ट सोशल स्टडीज लास्ट लेसन, इट वाज अबाउट फूड. लाइक क्लोथ्स, इट विल डिपेंड ऑन अवर क्लाइमेट एंड डिफरेंट रीजन, क्लोथ्स विल बी डिफरेंट लाइक दैट. फूड ऑल्सो डिफरेंट पार्ट्स, पीपल वेयर दे आर लिविंग, विच पार्ट दे, डिपेंडिंग ऑन द रीजन दे ईट डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ food. I think that was the last chapter. No, children, 1 minute, let me see. Food was the last chapter, I think. No, clothes was the last chapter. Food and clothes almost together, I did, no? So last chapter was it about like food, clothes also, it is dependent on the region and climate. And first of all, what we learned, why do we wear clothes? To cover our body first. Then second, clothes protect us from sunlight, then heat, rain, cold, insect bites. Okay. Plus, if we wear good clothes, we look smart also. Okay. That is one thing. And like our country is a very big country, which part you go, no, you see some difference. Like if you go to north, some their clothing habits is different. South you come, is their clothing habits is different. That we learned. And special occasion. Suppose somebody's birthday or any party is there or wedding is there. Marriage is there, special occasion, plus festival. We love to celebrate festivals. So different festival also, we wear grand clothes. Okay, so that much we learned, and we did the exercise also. Today we learned an important chapter. These and all you should know. Like children also, you should have knowledge about safety. What is first aid? You should have, so that you will be safe, is it not? So chapter is about safety and first aid. It is the last chapter. Science portion, it is the last chapter. So for next onwards, we'll start the in this one, SA2, semester 2 book. We'll start, I'll tell you. So today and maybe one more class, I will complete this chapter and we'll go for new book. Okay, by the time school also will be open. So we'll do. Now this is on page number 240, page number 240. Open the book also and keep it open, children. Pictures are there. It's easy to understand. See, this is page number 240. Lesson number 7, about safety and first aid. So about safety, what do you understand, children? Before that, you see this. This is very common sight at your home. Today, we'll discuss safety at home. In your book, it is there mainly about safety at home. But I'll discuss about how to be safe at school also, because few hours you stay spend at school also, no? Then outside on the road, that also we'll discuss. Before that, since we spend most of our time at home, so how to be safe at home? Because we think we take for granted. Like at home, we have so much freedom. Means we can touch anything, we can do anything, we can be ourselves. So there is no restriction because it is our home, it is our freedom. Freely we do everything. But most of the accidents because of our carelessness happens. Most of the accidents happen at home only. That only I'll discuss so that you will have some knowledge that how to be safe at home also. Many accidents occur actually at home because we spend most of the time and we are a little bit careless at home. Okay, so that only one by one I'll discuss. So before that, before I proceed, you see these pictures. At home is a common sight, no? Button will be there. Then this, when you play also, you don't arrange your toys and sometimes it will be lying like that only. As few things, it will be available. Means for small children, that is a dangerous thing. Because small children who are very baby, means like your brother or sister is there. Or when your babies also, few things happen. Means little accident, not major one. So how it happens, see, these are all buttons, like small buttons. It will be lying on the floor, coins. It will be there. Then pins, any sharp thing. Then scissor, kitchen you enter, means scissor will be there. knife will be there. When you do art and craft, that small scissor will be given. So it will be sharp thing. Knife also sharp thing. Then each and every house, liquid cleaner will be there, like Harpic or anything. A bathroom, if you go, miss, so many cabinet, inside cabinet, you can see so many bottles. But out of curiosity, if you don't know that thing, you don't go and touch that. It can be dangerous. Only mummy will be knowing, your daddy will be knowing for what work it is, what purpose they are keeping that. So parents also should be very careful. They should not keep children's range, means how much their hands go, or it should not be in front of their eyes. Means it should be in closed cabinet or some upper place, higher place, so that children, they should not reach. So parents also responsibility is there. So this thing, what happens to small babies and all, even your age also, some children, they do off. They put everything in their mouth. But the small thing, coin also, sometimes they keep in the mouth and it will go inside your throat. It is very dangerous. Pin, you can get cut. Then scissor also, you can get cut. Knife also, very sharp thing. So these are all not for you actually. So you should not have some knowledge though. You should not, you should be very careful with these things. If you see also it is lying, you keep and give to your mommy or elder one, whoever is there, you just show them and they will pick up and keep in safe place. This thing is very dangerous. Liquid cleaners and all, you should not touch. You should not open the bottle at all, because you don't know how to use that. That this work is not for you. So you should not touch. If you see also, don't go and touch and don't try to open this kind of bottles and all. Okay. And without asking, don't put other than food. Don't keep anything in your mouth. Some children, they have a habit. Everything they want to put in their mouth. It can be dangerous. It can be poisonous. So other than food, your mummy is serving food. Other than that, unknown thing, you don't put in your mouth. Okay. You don't know me, so don't put in your mouth. These are all, should be very careful. For that, this one. And one more thing, it is switchboard. All houses, switchboard will be there. Some appliances will be there, like mixie or iron. Then for fridge also connection will be there. So if you go and touch, if your hand is wet, means coming from bath or your hand is wet, little water also there, you touch means you will get shock. And major accidents also can happen. So no need to touch all this. And this pressing and all is not your work. Only to put light fan, that too, your hand should be dry. Your hand should be dried and always use slipper at home. So you won't get shock. Understood? Wet hand, you should not touch switchboard. Understood? And if it is little loose or wire is not properly fixed, you don't touch. You ask your elder one. Okay? You don't go and try to put the plug into the switchboard, or don't do any experiment. Okay? With electricity, you don't do any experiment. So now in details, I will. So these are overall, I'm telling, these are all sharp things you should not touch. Then liquid cleaner, you don't open the bottle and all. Coins and a small smoothie, don't put in your mouth. It can get stuck in your throat, then it is very dangerous. Then switchboard, very, very careful. With wet hand, you should not touch the switchboard. Unnecessary, don't go and play with the switchboard. No need. Okay. So that is one thing. Now one by one, I will explain. Open the page number 240 or so. Children, so many pictures are there. Now, safety at home, in details I will discuss, because most of the time we spend at home and we are very careless, because it is our home. We have so much freedom. Anything we can touch it. But it should be safe for us. Whatever we do, we should be responsible. You should know, if I do this, what will happen to me? Okay, so we'll discuss. So this much I'll rub now. This much you understood, children. Once again, I am not going to draw. You just see this. Okay, next one. Okay, today the safety. First aid, I will go to next class. Okay, first aid about that in details, I'll do next class. Now, safety means what you understood then? To prevent any accident, we should be very careful. That is only be safe. Understood what is safety means? So first you should have a knowledge. If you do this, what will happen? Okay, so that you know means, then you will be careful. You won't do that one. ओके दैट इज ओनली सेफ्टी, दिस चैप्टर इज अबाउट दैट ओनली. तो फर्स्ट विल स्टार्ट विथ सेफ्टी एट होम. सेफ्टी एट होम, इन सेफ होम विच इज द फेवरेट रूम फॉर अस, लिविंग रूम, बिकॉज देयर टीवी विल बी देयर, कंप्यूटर विल बी देयर, गेस्ट विल कम देयर, वी रिलैक्स इन लिविंग रूम. So there, apart from TV and all, many glass item like showcase, flower vase, so many delicate items also will be there, no? But some children, what they do, no? How accident happens in living room? Because they start playing there. They start playing there, then they run around with brother, sister, then they jump from the sofa. So all these things, you do unknowingly, you'll do it off. Sometimes you sleep, otherwise you play miss. That item can break. Glass items and all, you can damage your TV, you can damage your computer. Okay, so open the book, little I read important lines. I will read now. So this page I'm reading now. See, safety begins at home. Your home is a special place because it is the place where you grow, learn, play and sleep. So all work we do at home only. It is where you can find comfort, love and care. We stay with our family, no, there. So it is our favorite place, but sometimes more accidents happen when you, it is also a place where you feel safe, but it is a common place where you get injured. Not only accident, sometimes you get injured also. Now, safety at home. So, living room, I'll discuss now. Most accidents happen when you play and run in the living and dining room. Because children, they spend most of the time in the living room. Watch TV or they study or they play with us indoor games. They relax. Okay, you could knock down vase, miss so many things will be there, item will be there, I told you, no? So while playing, you can knock down vase, cabinet with books, plate or glass or steel vase, even the TV also, you can break that. So living room, what accident happens? Because there will be so many items will be there and we relax there. Some children knowingly, unknowingly, they start playing there. So in course of that, they break glasses, then flower vase, sometimes TV also they hit with the ball and all. So like that. And they also, while running around, they can fall because the sofa and all will be there. It can hit their head. So small, big, anything happen. So that is one thing, living room, how you get injured. Okay, living room, you understood, no? Page number 241 now. Next important room is kitchen. Because mommy prepares food, she spends most of her time in kitchen to prepare food for family and so many other work also will be there in the kitchen. But small children, what they do, no? Suddenly they will enter and on the stove, a hot vessel will be there because mommy will cook and keep, no? Unknowingly, they'll go and touch that you get, your hands get burnt. You understood? Because she's cooking and hot vessel she's keeping. Sometimes she is making dosa, chapati, that hot tawa, you will unknowingly, you will touch, you will get major burn in your hand. So that place is not for you. Kitchen, you should not enter unnecessarily. If you want to help, sometimes the children say, I want to help you. For mummy, they say, I want to help you. They want to cut with the sharp knife. So, but that work is not for you because until you're a little more brave, you grow more, little big, you should not go and cut vegetables. Other things you can do. You can set up the table, then fill your bottle, water bottle, then cleaning, little bit cleaning work you can do. Like that, you fit some things from the fridge to your mummy's hand. Like that way you can help your mummy, but cutting all, you are still small. You should not touch the scissor also, and knife, sharp knife, then hot vessel, without you, you don't go and touch. If you're hungry, your mummy will serve you. Okay, so that you tell your mummy that I'm hungry, you give me food. But you should not go unnecessary. Don't try to touch anything without knowing. If it is hot or cold, you don't know, don't touch. So, you can get hurt when you use sharp kitchen tools like knives, scissors, everything. So, if you want to help your mother in the kitchen, there are better ways. I told you, you can fill up water, then you can clean the dining table, then you can get things from the fridge and you can give for a mummy. All this work without touching hot vessel and scissor and knife, you can help some other way also for mummy. Okay, so that is one thing. Next, what I wrote, bathroom. Yes, bathroom. In bathroom also major accidents happen. Why, children? Because people will take bath and all, water will be falling on the floor. It will be slippery. So don't try to run or rush into the bathroom. Go slowly. Step by step you go. And when you are using soap or shampoo, you keep it up and pour water, because it should not be slippery. So after you, who is coming, they can fall. Especially if you have grandmother, grandparents at home, you should be very careful for them. If you have small baby also, you should have should be very responsible and safe. So bathroom, mainly that happens. They fall, they sleep because of soap, water and all. They can sleep. And it will be very small place, no? If you move more, then you can hit your head also, like that. Happens in bathroom. And especially I told you that cleaning agents normally, parents, they will keep in the cabinet. Don't try to open out of curiosity, because that is not your work. That cleaning bathroom is not your work. So you should not touch that one. Because unknowingly, sometimes mild acid will be there. And that is very dangerous, poisonous thing. Okay, you can burn your skin or you major accidents can happen. Don't try to experiment with all those bottles and all in the bathroom. Okay, so that is one thing. And hurry buddy, you should not enter, because water will be there, you can sleep. Understood? So that is how to be safe at bathroom, I told now. Stairs, that is also major place where accidents happen, because sometimes you get late for school or you want to go to play with your friends, somebody is calling from downstairs, you just rush down. You just rush. So that time what will happen? So obviously you can fall. And steps are very dangerous. You can hit your head, you can break your head, you can have fracture. So what is the hurry? You just come slowly. Come down slowly, go up slowly. Stairs, it is very, you should be very careful. Sometimes night time, if it is not, put on the light, see and see your steps. You should not rush down, okay? So that is one thing. Stairs also, children, they fall. Anybody can fall. And you should not put any water or any slippery thing on the steps. You should be very careful. Always put light on the night time and watch your step and you get down. Understood? So bathroom also I explained now. And you can see that one last para, you see this paragraph, you see this only I told. Some chemicals, detergent, cleaning liquid on the shelf in the bathroom, you can see all this. They are not for you. Okay, so don't ever try to remove them or use them yourself. Okay, no need to open that bottle, sir. No, that is dangerous. Okay, so now major thing, turn the page number 242. This picture I drew, you see. So this one, all houses, I told you, switchboard will be there. So there are electric connection and appliances all around your home. Appliances means like fridge, then mixie, and then press, iron press. So those are called appliances, okay? Because they run on electricity. So we have to switch on this one. But you can get electric shock if you touch open wire. Sometimes it is not closed. Some houses, old houses, wires will be open. It is not closed. So that you can get accident. You don't touch all those. Okay. You should not touch any open wire or plug point, because inside current will be there. If you touch like this, you have to put your finger or some children, naughty children, what they do, they put pencil inside the holes. They try to experiment. It's very, very dangerous. Okay? So don't play with the switchboard. And always stay away from them. Electric appliances and switchboard, you stay away from them. And don't touch with wet hand. I tell you, if water is there or you're coming out from your bath, taking bath and you're coming, your body will be wet. With that hand, don't touch the switchboard. You'll get shock. Sometimes in your house, you can see coin, button and pins. I told you, no? It will be lying around. Sometimes it falls. Don't put them in your mouth. You could swallow them accidentally. So look out. And in school also, it happens. Small, small rubber piece, eraser piece, and so many things you do are in the school also. So now you are a little bit, be responsible. Okay? Don't do all this. Okay? So one more time, because it's a long chapter, children. So today, next class I'll continue, because it's a long chapter. One day I cannot complete. So one more thing, one more time, I'll just discuss safety at home. Today I'll discuss only about safety. First aid I'll do the next class. So safety at home. Home, so many rooms are there: living room, kitchen, bathroom. Outside stairs are there. So in living room, so many items will be there: TV, then computer, then your glass item, showcase. So if you play and run around, you can break them, and you also can fall and you can get hurt. That is one thing you understood. Kitchen is very dangerous, because dangerous for children actually, because their hot items will be there, vessel will be there, then sharp items will be there. The children, out of curiosity, they want to go and play with those, but don't enter the kitchen until you call your mother. Okay, elder one is there, means you enter. Bathroom is also dangerous, because there soap and all, it will be watery, it will be slippery. So don't rush into the bathroom, go step by step. And inside cabinet, so many cleaning items will be there. Normally parents, they will keep there normally. So you don't go and open there, those bottles and all, that is not for you. Don't do. Stairs, when you are coming up and down, coming down or climbing up, be very careful. See your steps one by one. You don't rush and don't run on the stairs. You can sleep, you can injure your head and all. Anything can happen. Now, others I wrote, but today I am not. Others, so a little I'll tell you about others means. Like you, when you are walking on the road, no? If it is very lonely, means suppose afternoon time or late evening time, if it is lonely, you don't come out. Because you are small children, they're all people are not good, because all are not your friends. So don't talk to any stranger. Then, yeah, if you have to go out, you go with your elder brother, sister or parents, because you are small, no? You don't. When it is lonely, don't go and play. You want to do cycling or you want to play, but if it is lonely, when other people are there around, then you go. And if you have to go alone outside, you tell your parents where you are going and what time you are coming back. Understood? Go, don't go alone. And so that is only about this. Okay, so and don't talk to any strangers, because not all are your friends. Anybody ask for your address and all, sometimes it happens. You are going and somebody is coming very close to you. Don't go close to any stranger. You say, I don't know. And you move away from there. Okay? If anybody is following you, you go and inform your parents. So those are the safety at outside your home. You should know. Always accompany with elder ones. Okay? Understood? Next class, I will discuss more. So today up to here. Thank you, children. Have a good day.